This lesson is going to demonstrate how to get these images onto your website. So let's go ahead and get started. First off, you're going to want to design your PowerPoint because you want it to look kind of interesting. To do that, you would go to Design and you can choose from these various designs. Well, I picked this particular design. The only problem is I don't think the blue complements the color scheme of my website. So here's a little trick. I'm going to go ahead and click on the print screen button of the keyboard because I want to get a snapshot of my website so that I can pick up those colors in Photoshop. So I'm going to go ahead and open up Photoshop at this time. With Photoshop open, I'm going to do File, New. I'll say OK to that window, and then I'll do either Edit, Paste, or Control V on the keyboard. So now I can pick up the colors. So for example, if I wanted this dark purple as part of my color scheme, I would take the eyedrop tool in the tools window and I would pick up that color. Now notice in the tools window how it popped on top. I'm going to click on that and I'm going to get the RGB colors. This is kind of important. You write those down so that when you return to PowerPoint, you can incorporate those colors. So the RGB in this case is going to be 131. And then the other number is going to be 0 and then 79. So once you have the RGB colors that you picked up in Photoshop, you can return to your PowerPoint, click on the design ribbon, then go to the color option. Click on that drop down arrow and choose create new theme colors. Determine which color you want to change. So in this case, we're going to change accent 1. So go ahead and click on that drop down arrow. And you want to choose more colors. Make sure custom is selected, and then you change the RGB colors to the color that we just picked up in Photoshop. And now go ahead and say OK. And now click Save. And notice that it picked up that color from the website. The next demonstration is going to include changing the font title text if you so choose. You don't want to have to visit each slide and change the font. You do want consistency. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on the View ribbon, choose the Slide Master option, locate the slide that you want to change, and you can always experiment until you get it right. Select that text, right-click, and then choose the font that you want. You can change the color, and you can change the size. If you're happy with those changes, click on Close Master View, and you will see that font applied to your slides. Now, I don't know if you noticed that before is fine and after is fine, but this should probably be white. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go back to the view. We're going to choose Slide Master, locate that slide. So for example, if you wanted to keep that font, that's fine. You might want to actually increase the size. I'm going to increase it to 28. And I'll go over here and increase that to 28. But here I'm going to change the font to white. Once I've done that, I'm going to close the master, and you can see the changes that were made on these slides. So once you're happy with the results, we can go to the next step. I'm going to go ahead and save it. It's always a good thing to save. Now we're going to go to File, Save As. Now when this window pops up, see where it says Save As Type? Click on that drop-down arrow, and we're going to choose JPEG File Interchange Format. Okay, once you've done that, I'm just going to go to my desktop, and it will put a folder on my desktop for me. And I'm going to go ahead and leave the name, and I'm going to say Save. Now, when this window pops up, you want to say Every Slide, and now it's saved all the images. So now what we're going to do is those images are now on my desktop. You're going to have to locate that folder. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go to Photoshop at this time because I want to resize all those images so that I can add them on my website, resized to roughly 600 pixels wide, the same width as my banner. So I'm going to go to File, Open. I'm going to go to the desktop and locate that folder. So there it is. It's called Photoshop Portfolio. And there are the images. I'm going to go ahead and select just the images that I plan on resizing. So I'll select slide 2, I'll hold the shift key, and then click on slide 13. So I'll go ahead and open those. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say image size and set them all to 600 pixels wide. And then you're going to do File, Save for Web. And in this case, most likely a JPEG. I'll go ahead and do that demo. OK, Okay, right now it's a JPEG versus a GIF. Let's go back to JPEG. I don't know if you can see the difference in quality or not. Yeah, it's a little more pixelated as a GIF. And the general rule of thumb is save photographs as JPEG. So I'll set that to JPEG for all of them. I'm going to say save. And what you could do is go ahead and go back to that folder, maybe that Google site folder. And if you want, you can create another folder, right click and say new folder, and maybe I'll call it resized images. Whatever it takes for you to be organized, and you can find these later. So I'm going to go ahead and save that, and I'll close that out and not resave. And again, I'll do image size 600, then I'll go file save for web and make sure that I get it into that folder as a JPEG. And then I'm going to close this one out to stay organized and say no. And keep doing this until they're all resized to 600 pixels wide. Once you have resized your images, you can return to your Google site and start adding those images. So I'm going to go ahead and click on example one. I'm going to click on edit. So with the cursor where I want it, I'm going to say insert image. I'm going to go ahead and browse for that image and then locate the folder. And I put it in resized images and I'll start putting them in order. It doesn't matter where I put them. Say OK. And now click on Save. And now I'll go to example two and add the next image. So I'll go ahead and go into edit mode. I'll click on Insert Image. I'll browse and then click on the image that I want to insert and say OK. Make sure you click Save and you keep doing this until all your images have been added. So after adding a few images, I realized that I'm not real happy with how this is turning out. So I returned to PowerPoint and I actually made the font title match my color scheme. Now you kind of don't want to have to repeat this effort again, but now I have to go resave these as images, bring them back in to Photoshop, and resize it to 600 pixels wide, and then go back to the website and insert the images. So you kind of want to get the color scheme right the first time. I like to be a bit of a perfectionist, so I'm going to be working a little bit more to make this right. So I want to show you the changes that were made. This was before with the white text, and I actually went back into PowerPoint and changed the title fonts for before and after. This is after I made the changes. So I'm going to go ahead and continue adding all the images to the site, and we're almost done. There's one more really important step that you need to understand, and then we are through with all the videos for this project, and you should be complete. I just created this. Remember how to create a page? I created the page 11, and it should be showing up here in the left, but it's not. So what you want to do is you want to click on the More option and choose Page Settings. Make sure that you show this page in the sidebar. I'm going to go ahead and select that. I'm going to say Save, and it will pop up. Notice how it popped up under Thanks. So I'm going to have to go back into the Edit sidebar to change where it should be. I'm going to go to Edit under Sidebar here, and I'm going to go down here. If that's not showing, it's because you need to deselect Automatically Organize My Navigation. Click on Example. And I'm going to click on the arrow so it's right before Thanks. I'm going to say OK, save it, and then you can return to your website and you will see those changes made. This concludes the final session on creating a wonderful portfolio by putting your images, your wonderful images, on a Google site. I hope that you've gotten as much from this class as I have, and I'm so excited to see your work. Take care.